Hey there everybody, this is JT Bear coming to you from inside my greenhouse. Just wanted to give you a heads up on a couple of things if you're trying to do aquaponics in a less than perfect greenhouse, much like this one, and you haven't had your first winter frost and snow yet, you might be in for a few surprises. One thing you may discover is that peppers absolutely cannot tolerate the cold. These leaves basically died overnight. There will be no coming back from this point. And in just a matter of a day or two, the fruit is already looking wrinkled, and it's definitely time for that one to hit the compost pile. The pepper plant beside it looks the same, as does the one beside it. Whereas that oregano, that golden oregano that's been punished so much, doing just fine. The sage is fine, even the chives are fine, but the pepper that's there died overnight in the cold. As you can see, the Bolivian rainbow pepper did no better. I'm going to harvest that really soon and try and get as many seeds from it as I can. It's led a fairly isolated life, not a lot of other peppers in the greenhouse, so with any luck, those will breed fairly true and give me Bolivian rainbow hot peppers next year. Here we can see what I was hoping would be next year's crop of sweet gold cherry tomatoes, but they've looked like this since the first real frost. The experimental pepper growing in the bed beside them, also completely dead. While the much more resilient plants, like these mints, appear unharmed at all by the cold and happy to continue growing on. Most of the other herbs survived our first frost fairly well. Here you can see the rosemary is just fine. The miniature curry is fine. My treasured Cuban oregano, on the other hand, didn't make it through. Score one for the Italian and Greek varieties over my favorite, the Cuban. Winter survivability. Thankfully, I moved a very large plant of that into the house, so I do still have some growing. After the initial frost, the lettuce seems to have recovered itself fairly well, and the sage growing beside it seems to be doing quite nicely. This patch of chard also seems to have recovered fairly well from the first frost. What surprises me the most is that the curry seems to be doing better. I thought for sure I'd lose it, being a more tropical plant. But there you can see it's doing quite well, and it's the middle of November. Let's see what the temperature is in my greenhouse. So you can see the temperature there is reading at 10 degrees Celsius, give or take, or about 50 degrees Fahrenheit. The only sources of heat we have here in the greenhouse at the moment are the compost and a couple of submersible fish tank heaters, just to help prevent them from freezing. Speaking of freezing, the one issue we really did have that wasn't plant related was that ridiculously long irrigation pipe along the back froze solid on me and took several hours to thaw. So now I've got the setup with the heaters on at night, and I just turned the pump off so that it's free and clear and it flows well when I start it up in the morning. Well, that's all for now. Thanks for watching and have a great day.